Hello everybody, my name is Dmitry and in this video I will explain how the Astra theme was able to avoid a 6-week suspension on WordPress.org for multiple serious guideline violations. I've been very vocal about this issue from day one, so now that the story has somewhat concluded, it is time to look back and see what really happened. If your livelihood depends on WordPress in any way, I think that you should watch this video. I will explain why the Astra theme was suspended for 6 weeks from the WordPress.org theme repository and how they took advantage of over a million website owners. I will also show how the theme review team ignored the seriousness of these violations. Almost everything that happened in this situation went in Astra's favor and minimized their financial and reputational losses. It's a long and crazy story with a couple of convenient twists. So please watch until the end before you jump to any conclusions. If it gets too slow for you, you can increase the playback speed of this video and pause where you have to. The goal of this video is not to throw anyone under the bus. I have nothing personal against any of the people mentioned in this video. This is not meant as an attack on the character or personality of anyone. To quote the great Eric Weinstein, if we are equal, we should be able to call each other out when we are wrong. So grab a seat and let's begin with a story. Astra is the most popular free WordPress theme available on WordPress.org. It is the only non-default theme to have reached over 1 million active installations, with thousands of positive user ratings on the website. Using financial data provided by other theme developers in the past, I believe that Astra currently generates revenue of around $1.5 million per month from theme sales alone, so keep that number in mind while you listen to the rest of the story. Before I begin, it is important to establish some things. 1. Personally, I have nothing against the developers of the Astra theme. I have never had any interactions with them, nor have I ever used the theme itself. 2. The purpose of this video is to bring more attention to the way the themes section of the WordPress.org website is managed. 3. In the past, I had some public disagreements with the way the WordPress.org theme review team operated, a team that I was part of. In July of 2017, I published an article about the bias and preferential treatment by some members of the theme review team. It was read by about 1500 people in the first week and had some traction on Twitter. 3 years later, my article is still relevant. With that out of the way, let's look at what happened with Astra. On 7th of August 2020, it was a Friday, following an Astra theme update, the theme review team account posted a single comment on track announcing a 5-week suspension of a theme, citing the violation of the no affiliates link requirement. This came as a surprise to many. And here's what was discovered upon further inspection. When you use Astra, you get this Astra options page. At the bottom of the page, there was a section called Extend Astra with free plugins. This block contained a simple list of plugin names and an activate button for each plugin. Clicking the activate button would automatically download and activate the plugin. The problem was that all but two of these plugins are owned by Astra. The two plugins that have nothing to do with Astra are HubSpot and Google Analytics Dashboard. Astra is an affiliate for both of these plugins. One could argue that these plugins are recommended not because of their worth, but because of an undisclosed commercial relationship. For example, if you activate HubSpot and go to the settings page, the plugin requires an account. If you register that account through this button, you become a referral of Astra. If you ever decide to upgrade to a paid package, they will get a significant reward. The affiliates page on HubSpot promises a commission of $250 for the starter plan and $1,000 for the enterprise plan. So we're not talking about a few cents here and there. But it doesn't end here. They would also inject their affiliate code into upgrade links for other plugins that were already active on the same website. These plugins are WP Forms, active on 3 million websites. Ninja Forms, active on 1 million websites. GiveWP, active on 90,000 websites. And Social Snap, active on 10,000 websites. For example, let's look at the Ninja Forms plugin, active on over 1 million websites. When you go to the Ninja Forms add-ons page in the backend, Astra adds their affiliate link into all these Learn More buttons. So every add-on that is purchased by an Astra user will get them commissions. The same is for WP Forms, active on over 3 million websites. The affiliate link was on the plugin's landing page, and all other plugin pages where an upgrade link was visible. It is important to note that all these affiliate links have never been disclosed as affiliate links. I will not go into the legal side of doing this, that's not my area of expertise, but I can say that this is shady and somewhat dishonest. They have been doing this for 18 months. Now that we have established what the theme was suspended for, let's see what actually happened next. 40 minutes after announcing the suspension, the Astra developer account explained their position and requested a reconsideration of the punishment. Around the same time, the CEO of the company behind Astra started a discussion in the theme review channel on Slack. There was some back and forth between the theme review team leaders and the Astra representative, but the position of the TRT looked firm. The legal aspect of undisclosed affiliate links was brought up, but it mostly went unaddressed. The first thing that looked odd to me was this comment by the Astra CEO. First, Sujay tried to point out that plugins already add affiliate links and it's not a big deal, even though he should be well aware that plugins and themes have different rulebooks. The Brainstorm Force company has 42 plugins in the repository, so they are not new to this. They know the rules. In the second sentence, Sujay did two things at once. He tried to leverage the 1 million users of the Astra theme, but he also brought up the difficult times caused by the Tom Hanks disease. After that, he leaned on again on the popularity of Astra and how video tutorials about Astra would confuse thousands of new users every day and so on. An important side note. In an announcement blog post dated September 11, 2020, the Astra team mentioned that it took them 14 months to grow from 100,000 active installations to 500,000 active installations, and only 8 months to double that number to 1 million. So the Astra CEO tried to sway the theme review team's decision using the financial difficulties argument, while in reality, Astra's growth has only accelerated. Coming from one of the most successful theme developers in the world, I find that argument to be very dishonest. If you read through the full discussion on Slack, you will notice that the Astra CEO deflects and downplays the issue in every comment, while treating some members of the theme review team like naive children. When asked if the company earned money from the affiliate links, he said that they did not get paid for adding the links, but would get paid affiliate earnings. When asked if they disclosed the affiliate relationship of the links, he said that they did not recommend or require these plugins, so any legal regulations are not applicable. Sujay then goes to offer an alternative punishment, that they publicly announce what happened and promise to never do it again, as well as advise others not to break guidelines. After some more back and forth, the decision seemed final and set in stone. The theme will be suspended for the announced 5 weeks, that is until 11th of September 2020. Later in the day, Sujay mentioned again that the theme being suspended doesn't benefit anyone and will only harm a lot of users. It is still undetermined how the Astra users would have been harmed during these 5 weeks. While all this discussion was happening, some major media outlets have picked up the story. The Search Engine Journal was among the first ones to do so. At the time of recording this, their article was shared over 850 times and was viewed more than 100,000 times. On August 9th, 2 days after the suspension, an apology letter was published by the Astra team. However, the apology letter was edited a few times after going live. According to multiple trustworthy sources, the original apology contained a promise to sponsor WordCamp events and other financial contributions to the community. Later that day, the post was edited and all mentions of financial contributions were removed. According to the theme review team representatives, the team was not consulted and these financial contributions were not discussed nor approved. I am among the many people that felt and still feel that the apology letter was worded in such a way as to deflect any responsibility for the guideline violations. Actually, there are two different Astra apology letters. One is a post and one is a page. First, let's look at the earlier one, as it's not easily available. I think they forgot to delete it from their website. The letter says that the theme was suspended. They then mention the fact that they have been adding affiliate links to 6 different plugins, but they downplay their actions by mentioning that Astra used officially provided functions to do so. They then falsely claim that the guidelines for these were changed and that they merely overlooked the fact. The No Affiliates Link guideline was officially announced on 26th of September 2018, 5 months before they started injecting their first affiliate link. The letter goes on to say that they are sorry for overlooking this specific policy. They are not sorry for the links. They are not sorry for not disclosing their financial interest in promoting these plugins. They are not sorry for taking advantage of their users. They are sorry for being caught. Now let's look at the final form of the letter as it is available today on the blog. The Astra theme was delisted temporarily as a result of a guideline violation. Not suspended, but only delisted. As a result of a guideline violation. There were 6 violations, not one. But not a single word in this letter is about the actual violations. They deleted the part about the links. I guess that part is not important. They are so committed to their users and the community that they didn't even address their violations. But this was only the beginning of this crazy story. While the Astra team were writing and rewriting their apology letter, in the early Sunday hours of 10th of August, a meta ticket was created on WordPress.org by a core contributor. It would allow the theme review team to delist themes from the repository, not just suspend them. What's the difference? A suspended theme disappears completely from the website. It cannot be updated or downloaded. A delisted theme would still be visible on the website, but only if accessed via a direct link. The ticket says that it shouldn't appear in search results. We'll get to this part later. Astra was reinstated on the WordPress.org website. Right after that, a new member joined the theme review Slack channel and praised the Astra apology letter. He forgot to mention that he works for the company behind Astra. Whoops. At this time, people started reading and reacting to the apology letter in its many variations. Theme review team representatives had negative reactions. For example, Ari's comment: "As a user, I think it's a joke. Good for marketing and clever wording that makes it appear as if the team behind Astra did nothing wrong, when in fact they violated the trust of the theme team and the trust of users." This is when I got involved with a story. I decided to start with some lighthearted sarcasm and point out the fact that this new delisted status was quickly proposed to fit the Astra case. Instead of suspending it like any other theme, there is now a middle option for delisting themes. Poena confirmed my assumption that an important meta team member had to drop everything on a Sunday to handle this issue. This problem existed since the beginning of days, and all it took was for Astra to be suspended for 36 hours and the problem was finally resolved. I have stated my opinion that if Astra was any less popular, then the theme would have been suspended just like other themes in the past. Ari, the TRT representative, partially agreed with my position and confirmed the social and media pressure caused by this issue. A few hours later, a post by Justin Tedlock went live on WP Tavern. It was a good summary of everything that happened up to that point, and I appreciate Justin's ability to present things from different angles. The reader comments mostly agreed with the severity of the issue and the dishonesty of his behavior. So here's where we are in the story. It is Monday, 10th of August. The world knows that Astra is suspended for 6 weeks until 18th of September. Meanwhile, Astra is doing quite well on the website. The theme is visible in the search results, the theme is visible on the archive pages, business is back to normal. The meta ticket that would allow for a theme to be delisted is under review. Nonetheless, Astra's suspension was downgraded, awaiting for this ticket to be approved and committed. When I continued bringing up the fact that no real punishment has been applied, different theme review team members have started backpedaling. The multiple violations were no longer so severe. Chris Brewer summed up Astra's behavior quite nicely. In their first apology letter, they promise financial contributions, which then they delete after getting their theme back on. Joyously refers to the fact that Astra is not actually delisted and that the announced penalty does not correspond to the proposed meta ticket. Chris Brewer mentions that people are laughing that the Astra theme is back in the directory, and that from the outside it looks as if they were not punished at all. Later in the evening, a user named Jordan asked what ended up happening with Astra. An unusually long thread was started. Many people and some theme review team members have voiced their opinion that the suspension should be upheld. Danny Cooper asked if a penalty was downgraded because the TRT decided so themselves or someone nudged them. William and Poena said that no one nudged them, and I believe them. During the next day on August 11th, a different theme developer came into the Slack channel and voiced their disagreement. They had more than 35 themes suspended for 3 months without any kind of consideration for their users. Even though their case is much more complex and contains a lot more violations, what is important is how the theme review team representatives replied to these comments. First, Ari said that they are still working on finding a solution in the Astra case and that this has not ended yet. Then Poena admitted that the delisting attempt did not work and that without a meta patch we won't see the final results. I asked if in the meantime the penalty should not revert to its original form, to which Poena replied that is still undecided. Later in the day, Ari reiterated that the team treats all cases equally, disregarding the popularity of the theme. He also claims that the string of events related to Astra is just a random thing with no real meaning. Later that same day, Ari again expressed his position that Astra was treated just like any other theme, and that people that are angry might have some personal emotional issues. The discussion continued, with the attitude of some TRT members changing even more. There were now talks of learning from mistakes and making better decisions moving forward. When I brought up again the fact that a new penalty was invented specifically for the Astra case, William was quick to point out that this idea was discussed for years, so instead of proving me wrong, this only made my case stronger. Then William said that the team will do better with fair treatment going forward, to which joyously pointed out that this exact part is what makes this all unfair. A few minutes later, William summed up the current status of Astra. Even though the meta ticket is supposed to add the option of delisting a theme, currently the Astra theme was simply deranked on the popular page. While all this was happening, the Astra theme was sitting in the top 10 themes in the popular tab of the themes page. After this was pointed out, William refused to suspend a theme that already had its issues fixed. A user named Michael Bourne asked why testing a new core feature nullified the original suspension entirely, to which admins did not reply. I then posted a funny meme that fits the situation well, but for some reason it was taken very harshly by some. I followed up with another meme, this one was taken a little better. A few minutes later, Poena said that no one suspends a theme for that reason, probably meaning that having affiliate links is not a sufficient reason for suspension. It's odd to claim this after 4 days since this all started. So I expressed my feeling that public opinion was used to put some pressure on people with power to change things, and that has led to this weird sequence of events. Kevin summed up again the position of those that were vocal. Most offers just wanted to see equal treatment, but the Astra case had very clear and telling signs of special treatment up to that point. A few hours later, WordPress 5.5 was released. I also have to mention the article by Taylor Walden on August 12. In her article, Taylor argues that Astra's violations are not that bad and that the guideline itself should be reconsidered, Before you read the full article, I think it is important to note that Taylor works for Impress LLC, the company that owns the GiveWP plugin, one of the 6 plugins that Astra had affiliate links for. In that article, there is a comment by Carolina. That comment explains that this is not Astra's first guideline violation, but it was actually the third. By 13th of August, many people moved on and stopped bringing up the Astra case. But on 17th of August, on a Monday, I brought it up again, which got out of hand quickly. I made a reference to a very bad historical event in the past, which was incorrectly interpreted as a comparison. I was quickly warned both in public and in private that I will be banned if I continue in that manner, so I kept my mouth shut for a while. On 26th of August, the next day after a theme review team meeting and 19 days since the suspension of Astra was announced, I brought up the topic again. I pointed out that the theme continues to be visible everywhere on the website and in search results, contrary to the announced penalty of delisting it. I have also pointed out that their downloads number did not suffer in any way, so the penalty had no real effect or consequences. This discussion was quickly dropped. On 7th of September, I brought up this issue again. The initial suspension term of Astra was 11th of September. The meta ticket for the delisting feature was not yet implemented, even though it was so rushed previously. So I asked if the last 4 weeks of deranked status counted as 4 weeks of the initial suspended or delisted status, to which I did not get a definitive answer. On 8th of September, 3 days before the initial Astra suspension end date, the meta ticket for delisting themes was finally approved and committed, and 3 hours later I saw that Astra was finally removed from the popular page and from search results. But the very next day this patch was reverted, as it was suspected that it caused an issue with an unrelated part of the website. Even though 8 hours after the revert it was confirmed that this patch did not cause the bug in the system, the patch was not applied again. To this day, 14 days after the revert and with 4 requests from a TRT representative, the patch has not yet been reapplied. So Astra was back again on the popular page and in search results. Sensing what is happening, on 10th of September I asked how long will Astra's delisting last after the patch will be reapplied again. Ari decided to get personal and asked what would satisfy me. Then he casually mentioned that a penalty's start date is the date when a violation was discovered and not the actual date when a penalty was applied. He would go on to say that the theme was currently in good standing and no longer violated the guidelines, after pointing out again how this situation continues to look bad from the outside. Ari decided to call me a troll and stopped responding. Another person in the channel accused me of using this situation to benefit from exposure. Not sure what exposure, as I haven't written or published anything anywhere, with the exception of Slack and a few comments on the WP Tavern article. William's final statement on the subject introduced the new concept of a mix of penalties for guideline violations. It can be a mix of derank, delist and suspend, but it will last for the announced duration of 6 weeks. Another new concept that for some reason had to be introduced specifically during the Astra situation. And finally, on 21st of September, the Astra theme was back on the popular page in its original number 2 spot. So to summarize what happened. The theme's initial announced punishment was 6 weeks of suspension. In reality, they had 48 hours of suspension, about 36 hours of being truly delisted, and 6 weeks of being deranked by 70 positions on the popular themes page on WordPress.org. Looking at the historical downloads per day chart, we can see the real effect of the applied penalties. The 2 days of suspension cost them about 10,000 downloads. Then the 2 days of being delisted went completely unnoticed. The spike on September 11th is because of a theme update on the same day. Looking back at the whole situation, you can't help but notice how many things went in Astra's favor. The core meta ticket that was urgently created for them was left abandoned right after the theme was unsuspended. The attitude of some theme review team representatives changed from one of strong indignation to one of forgiveness and understanding. They even went through a lot of trouble to defend Astra from any real penalties. The complete disregard to the seriousness of these unethical actions on the part of the Astra theme developers. In the last 18 months, millions of websites were affected by this, yet it was ignored. Why did this all happen as it did? As harsh as I might have sounded at the time, I don't believe that any theme review team representatives had any personal or financial interests in resolving this issue one way or another. I honestly believe that everyone tried to handle this situation to the best of their abilities. Having said that, I think this situation was handled terribly. Some honest mistakes were made, but instead of admitting to them, TRT representatives doubled down. Instead of admitting early on that the delisting option is not a viable penalty in this situation, they decided to go with it, knowing full well the optics of doing so. But what troubles me the most is the cognitive dissonance of some theme review team members. All this time their concern was for the users of Astra and how a suspension would affect them, yet they chose to ignore the fact that Astra was injecting undisclosed affiliate links into third-party plugins that had nothing to do with the theme. Users were taken advantage of. Astra was also actively promoting products that had nothing to do with it, just because they had a financial interest in doing so. That is unethical and even illegal in some parts of the world. But for some reason, the TRT admins decided to ignore the seriousness of these violations. We are talking about millions of websites in the span of 18 months. And if you want to argue that injecting affiliate links is okay, then let's change the rulebook and allow everyone to do so. I guess what I wanted to accomplish with this video is to highlight how fragile the WordPress.org theme repository is, especially the organizational structure behind it. It is run by volunteers who don't have a say in many things, yet they are also able to casually take decisions that could make or break a business, without any transparency or being held accountable. When Zerif Lite was suspended back in 2016, it had 200,000 active installations and was generating about $70,000 per month for its parent company. But Astra is many times bigger, not just in the number of active installations, but also the economy that is built around it. It is not enough to just multiply by 5 the numbers that Zerif Lite had in 2016. If I look at the estimated revenue of Divi and Avada, then I am very comfortable in guesstimating that Astra is currently generating about $1.5 million per month, just from theme sales. And I won't be surprised if it's 2 or 3 million per month. Imagine how much of that revenue would be lost if Astra was really suspended for the 6 weeks. With an average of 5,000 downloads per day, that would be over 200,000 downloads in the 6 weeks. So it's not that surprising that Astra CEO's first reaction was to try and throw some money at the problem to make it go away. Would they have lost $1 million because of his suspension? Probably not, but I'm sure that they would have lost at least $200,000 or $300,000, as well as a huge reputation hit. So the next time when the theme review team makes a decision based on the intuition of a couple of unpaid volunteers, that decision could have immense real-world consequences, both positive and negative. And that's the end of the story of Astra's suspension. If you think that I missed some important information or provided some false information, please leave a comment and I will try to address it. Please look at the comment section. There might be some important information and updates from other people. If you are new to my channel, you can subscribe for more videos about WordPress news, themes, and plugins. My name is Dmitry. Have a nice day.